Welcome to my today's session on what are the dental instruments. In my today's instrument video, we are going to see what are the dental instruments, what are the dental elevators, and what is a basic surgical kit for we use for a dental extraction or the wisdom tooth surgical procedure. Today I am going to cover in my today's session is only dental extraction forceps. So let us start with the extraction dental forceps, right? Basically, we use two types of main extraction forceps. One is a maxillary extraction forceps, second one is a mandibular dental extraction forceps. These are the main types of extraction forceps. So let us see what are the different types, right? How to identify which one is a maxillary forceps and which one is a mandibular forceps, right? Generally, maxillary extraction forceps are in a straight plane, yeah, in which is a having in one plane. But in mandibular extraction forceps, you can able to see the handle, the and the fulcrum and the working area is at the 90 degree to the each other. So here we can see all the mandibular extraction forceps are the angular forceps. This is a basic identification mark in the maxillary and mandibular extraction forceps. Basically, this mistake is done by the newer students or the just intern student. So for the practitioner who has done the practice more than 5 years, they don't have this kind of problem. Okay, so let us start what are the extraction forceps, right? This is a basically a maxillary anterior extraction forceps. So this is, we can able to see there is a no space between the maxillary anterior forceps. So we can use this extraction forceps in here. We can able to see, we can hold this extraction forceps like this and we can extract, view the rotation forceps, and we can take in out the tooth, right? The second one is a, this is a premolar forceps. So there is always a slump kind of a slant in the maxillary extraction forceps and the premolar forceps. What is the basic difference in maxillary anterior and premolar forceps? There is an angulation and some kind of space between. So we can able to hold this premolar like this and we can extract the premolar forceps, right? So now this is a molar forceps. So we can able to see there is a small big between the one end of the extraction forceps. This beak is engaged for the engage of the between the two roots, buccal roots of the molar forceps. So these are the always a pair maxillary molar forceps. These are the pair instruments. So this is for the mostly on the patient's left side, right? So we can able to hold this extraction forceps to the molar like this. So this tip goes between the buccal two roots and this beak goes to the palatal root, right? So this is for the second quadrant of the maxillary molar forceps. This maxillary molar forceps is for the first quadrant, right? So how I am able to identify? Because this root, this tip, small tip is on the left side, right? So we can able to hold like this, right? We can give the rotation and buccal movements and we can able to extract the tooth. I am showing this all small demos on my dummy mandible, right? So exact extraction is not possible. Okay, these are the two cow horn forceps, right? The cow horn, why it is called cow horn? Because the one beak is like a cow horn, right? We can able to see, and the palatal engagement beak is having a crater like portion. We can able to see here, right? This is also a paired instrument, right? As we know, this beak is always go to the furcation of the buccal maxillary two roots, right? So this is for the second quadrant. So the cow horn will go to the on the buccal side always. Here also cow horn go to the buccal side. So this is for the first quadrant, right? this is a maxillary third molar force. How we can able to see? Because this is a typical angulation. So the forceps can go to the deep to the maxillary third molar forceps, and forceps will hold the maxillary third molar and will help to extract the tooth, right? Okay, this is called a maxillary root piece forceps or bayonet forceps. This is mostly for single root extraction, right? This is a maxillary forceps only. Let us start with the mandibular forceps. As I said, mandibular forceps is always 90 degree angulation, right? So this is a maxillary anterior forceps. So we can able to hold this forceps like this, rotate the tooth and take out the tooth like this. Okay, this is the single instrument. This is a premolar, mandibular premolar forceps. As I said earlier, mandibular forceps, premolar forceps is having always a small gap between it, right? So this will engage the my premolar like this, right? And we can able to take out this, right? Okay. This is a mandibular molar forceps, right? So it is always having a two beaks and having a one small sharp edge on the buccal side. So it will go to the buccal side, right? Like this. This is also mandibular molar forceps. We can hold the tooth like this. We can you rotate and buccal, rotate and buccal movement like this and for the extraction, right? This is a, as I showed, this is a mandibular cowhorn forceps. The two beaks are like the cowhorn only. So we can able to use this for the deep roots of the mandibular molar. So the my forceps will engage the furcation of the tooth and hold the at the furcation level, and we can able to take out the extraction forceps, right? As I said earlier, the position of the operator and the patient is I have described in my earlier videos. So please subscribe my Oral Surgery and Beyond YouTube channel for the further learning extraction method and the surgical videos, right? This is a mandibular third molar forceps. As I said earlier, this is for the posterior engagement like this, and we can able to take out this extraction of the mandibular third molar, right? This is a mandibular third molar cowhorn forceps, mostly for the third molar root pieces extraction. We can hold this forceps like this and take out the tooth like this, right? As I said earlier, before the forceps elevation, I always use the elevators and luxator. This is for the basic forceps identification method. In my next video, I will cover the what are the dental elevators and how to use it. Okay, thank you for today.